than those same jobs paid 20 years ago. Why is it that over the last 30 years we have seen a massive transfer of wealth from the pockets of working people into the hands of the top one-tenth of 1%? Why is it that today, and listen to this, because this is really pretty shocking. Why is it today that the top one-tenth of 1% now owns almost as much wealth as the bottom 90%? Why is it that the wealthiest 20 people in this country now own more wealth than the bottom 150 million Americans, half our population?
They own the politicians!
Why is it that at a time of a proliferation of millionaires and billionaires, we have the highest rate of childhood poverty of almost any major country on earth? Brothers and sisters, together, we are going to change that. We are going to create an economy that works for workers, that works for our children, that works for seniors, that works for veterans, and not just works for the top 1%. Now, Secretary Clinton and I have a whole lot of differences in terms of our views, in terms of our votes, in terms of the positions that we have taken over many, many years. I want to talk about one which is of enormous consequence to the workers in Ohio, and in fact, throughout this country. When I was first elected to the United States Senate in the early 1990s, the issue of NAFTA, North American Free Trade Agreement, surfaced. And what corporate America, and what the Republicans, and what some of the Democrats were saying, this is gonna be a great agreement, gonna create all kinds of jobs in America. I didn't believe that for one second. And in fact, in the early 1990s, I was on the picket lines in opposition to NAFTA. And years later, I opposed an even worse trade agreement, permanent normal trade relations with China. You didn't need a PhD in economics to understand that a trade agreement written by corporate America was designed to force American workers to compete against desperately poor people all over the world. And in my view, American workers should not have to compete against people making pennies an hour. And the results of NAFTA, the results of the trade agreement with China, is that this country has lost millions of decent paying jobs. Communities around this country, here in the Midwest, in Ohio, Michigan, Illinois, have been devastated. Since 2001, this country has lost almost 60,000 factories. 60,000 factories. And many of the jobs that were lost were good paying jobs, union jobs, jobs with health care, decent benefits. And when workers lost those jobs, they were forced, in many instances, to take jobs that pay half the wages and often without any benefits at all.